So I did a little conversion here for my sister's grill, and it worked amazingly well. So this is a propane grill, and I went from propane to natural gas. I just looked up the chart online for the orifice size for each individual burner BTU. I think it was 12,000 per burner, right?
48,000 total.
So it was 9,600 per burner. So I just looked on the chart for 9,600 for natural gas, ordered the drill bit that matched the orifice size, and then I drilled out the orifices. Here's the orifice for the side burner. Let me show you how well this worked. Check this out. So this is the original orifice size to use with propane, and then this one is after I drilled it. And that's on high. And as you can see a little yellow in the camera, but there's no yellow tips on the flame, which means that it's the appropriate amount of oxygen. And the side burner, let's see. All right, so that's before I drill the orifice, and this is after. Yep, looks like a full-size burner to me. That's it, they're all working. Look at that. So yeah, I just wanted to share that with everybody before they go and buy the conversion kit like she was gonna do. You might wanna look into doing this method here, the simple method. But I have to warn you now, I know a guy who got third degree burns on both of his arms because he didn't listen to me. He did the other way around. He got a natural gas griddle and hooked it up to propane, and those orifices are too big, and it just started shooting flames. So you can only drill it bigger if you're going from propane to natural gas. So this was bought as a propane grill, and I converted it to natural gas. I just wanted to share that with everybody because I thought that was pretty cool, and it worked so well. But disclaimer, I'm not telling you to do it this way. Make sure you check the chart and test it before you use it.